Hello and welcome. I am Rick Arter. Today I'll be taking a look at the 125th scale Revell 1932 Ford Rat Roaster model kit. This is from the TV show by Stacy David called Gears. He built this on the show and they built a model of it. This is a brand new release. Just came out in the beginning of 2013. It is labeled as a 2012 model, but it actually just was recently released. It's a skill level 2, which will require you to have paint and glue to assemble the model. Taking a look around the box, you can see on the front here they have a photo of the car built up and Stacy David standing next to it, pretty much just like they have in the TV show. Some information and a paint guide. Kit is 6¾ inches long, features 148 parts, molded in white. You have chrome, clear, red, probably red translucent parts for taillights, vinyl tires. Some information about the car and the show. Same photos on the sides. Here they give you some more pictures of the kit built up. They also include the guitar there, which is nice. Upon opening up the kit, things nicely bagged up in individual bags. Chrome plated parts, there's two trees inside. So your white molded parts in their own bag. Separate body. This is what I'm seeing with a lot of these new Revell kits. There's your clear parts and the wheels and tires. Or I should say just the tires, I'm sorry. Wheels would be here on the chrome plated parts tree, obviously. And you have the decals. Very nice. Nothing too fancy, but goes along exactly with the Rat Roaster theme. Obviously you could build this kit other ways, but this is the main idea of what it was built for. Typical Revell instructions, some photos, information about the kit, you got a paint guide, then the parts layout here in the front, and then your typical exploded diagrams, everything looks nice. And on the back, the decal placement. Give you guys a quick close-up look at some of this stuff before I move on to the white molded parts. The wheel and tire combination in this kit is fantastic. The detailing is amazing. This kit is worth the price for those alone. Decals are also very, very nice. I believe these to be parts for the interior. Could be wrong, but that's what it looks like. Some gauge faces, stripes, small sponsorship decals. There's this small amount of clear parts. Your headlights and the windshield chopped down. Here's your chrome plated parts. There's those wheels I was speaking of. Everything looks excellent. Chrome plating is very nice. There's a few little things here and there you're gonna have to trim up, but other than that everything looks good. Here's your disc brakes. Option for fender or non-fender version. They have two different intakes, which I was kind of confused about at first, but you have two air cleaner options. You can run flat style with the hood or the taller style. They have supercharged. It's a Wyand 250, I believe. It's your chrome plated valve covers. So there is some chrome, but it's not too much, just what it should be to replicate the kit. They have the side pipes and everything there. There's your moon tank. So overall, the chrome plated parts and everything else so far look really, really nice for the kit. Take one last look at those tires. I really love those. Here are all the white molded parts that are included in the kit. There are four white molded parts trees plus the chassis and the body itself. Overall, everything looks excellent. The casting, hardly any flash. You know, just typical stuff you're going to see with these new Revell kits. Just awesome detailing. Nothing you're really going to have to do, just, you know, cut them off. A few little things here and there you got to mess with, but other than that, I mean, there's not a whole lot of flash, no warpage. Nothing wrong with the parts that I can see, so let me give you guys... Here's all the white molded parts in detail. Let me show you a quick close-up of the body to start. Excellent engraving, casting, everything looks awesome. I don't see any problems with the body whatsoever. It's very straight. Moving on, here's your engine. And you have your frame. Simplified yet Nice casting part. Very nicely detailed interior. Replicate the Ret Roaster. There's your guitar that's included. Some interior parts. Your seats. Your floor pan. They include a separate interior floor pan. It's really nice to see. Really nice gauge panel there. Dashboard. This has your rear end, your brakes, shocks, radiator assembly, exhaust. Really sweet looking parts, drive shaft. And this last parts tree has your fenders, inner fender wells, firewall, radiator with the electric fan there with the other shroud part over here. And there's your really cool hood, which is an option to use. Excellent detailing. So really nice looking stuff. There's a bit of flash there, it looks like. Might just wait be. Nope, that's just the way it's molded. So awesome parts overall. After taking a good look at the Revell 32 Ford Rat Roaster Stacy David Gears Edition model kit, I definitely recommend this kit. Everything look awesome. The wheels and tires are alone are worth a purchase. You can only build this pretty much as this version. However, you know, you can always get creative and kit bash and do whatever. But the sole purpose of this kit was to build it as a replica of what he did on the show. And they do an excellent job of that. Everything looks amazing. I'm assuming this is a brand new tooling and mold and everything, except for probably some of the frame parts, since they're probably carryovers from the standard 32 Ford. But overall, guys, like I said, parts look great, decal sheet instructions, everything's amazing. Definitely recommend it. So I thank you all for watching. Comment, rate, subscribe, and I'll see you all soon.